Welcome to this edition of A Quick Conversation with President Ribeau. Today's conversation is about the President's Commission on Academic Renewal, also known as PCAR.
PCAR is a process designed to renew, to strengthen, to enhance the quality of our academic programs so that our students and our faculty and our staff are part of an academic community that is a leader amongst academic communities throughout the world. I think you have to start in the discussion of Howard University and its future by looking at our academic programs. We must do that. We must do that on a regular basis. PCAR is an attempt in a holistic way to do that, to look at what we teach, why we teach it, the pedagogy that surrounds it, the research that we do. So we're looking at why we have created a curriculum that has the courses that we offer, that has the teaching methods and modes that we offer, and have the disciplines we offer. Right now we have over 180 academic programs. There's no magic about that number. Should that number be 150? Should it be 200? Well, the answer to that question rests with where is the student demand, the student interest, the faculty expertise. I think what's very, very clear is that we can't do everything excellently. And if we want to be one of the top metropolitan research universities in the country of any kind, then we need to focus on what we do best, create the cognitive support areas to help us do that, attract the faculty that allow us to participate and be competitive, retain those faculty members after we attract them, and have the facilities that are required to make all this happen. We have a responsibility to our students at the undergraduate level, at the graduate level, to our professional communities, to the organizations that hire our students, to assure that our students are the best prepared of any they might consider to hire at their organizations. And the other thing that I think that that it's important to understand about this process is that it's being conducted in a way, you know, that's consistent with the values of the academy. The academy has been referred to as by scholars before me as a clear and open space. You know, it's a space where intellectual dialogue and discourse and ideas are exchanged and things are debated and discussed. And through that dialectic process, you get a better idea. You know, so the assumption is that, you know, through exchange of ideas and information, you get learned people from a variety of different disciplines that care passionately about their institution and the mission of their institution, that you can strengthen the fabric of all that you do. And the way that this is being conducted has to do with not just the content and the metrics and the assessment, it's the process, and this is important. It's the values of the academy that says that we participate in dialogue and discussions that help us become better. We self-reflect. We have a reflective process that helps us improve the quality of what we do. The President's Commission on Academic Renewal, and it's captured in the term academic renewal. We must continue to assess and to reflect on what we're doing, how we're doing it, how we might do it better, because that process is what brings you excellence or quality. We're talking about Howard University now, but I would say the same thing about any other large, complex organization. You have to look at what you're doing. If I am, as a faculty member, teaching the same course the same way that I taught it 30 years ago, and the body of knowledge and the research in that area has expanded the parameters of that discipline, then I have to stop and think about whether or not I'm providing the best instruction to the students I'm teaching. The President's Commission on Academic Renewal has a very clear set of expectations and a definite timeline. The Commission has been meeting throughout the latter part of the fall semester and will meet throughout the entire spring semester. And what they're charged to do is to come up with a series of recommendations about centers of excellence, program strengths, changes they'd like to see being made in the academic program and academic offerings here at Howard University, areas they think need to be strengthened, areas that in some cases they think need to be eliminated or modified. Answering questions such as, should we have more interdisciplinary programs? You know, should we have more programs that are focused on student learning outcomes and what students learn more so than what we think that we're teaching them? So they'll answer those kinds of questions. They'll give me a series of recommendations by the end of May. As the recommendations come to me, those will be posted on the web. My response to those will be posted on the web, and then I'll get feedback from the academic community. I'll take that feedback and I'll finalize a report that I will be submitting in June to the Board of Trustees. And that will lead to modifications and changes and recommendations for what we might do to improve, to enhance, to strengthen our academic programs. One of the outcomes I hope of PCAR is to come up with a framework to allow us to have more competitive salaries for our faculty. In addition to that, I hope what comes out of this is, you know, some decisions about where do we really consider our academic strengths to be at the undergraduate level and at the graduate level.
Join us next time for a quick conversation with President Ribeau.